Hello and welcome to today's English class. Students, A Long Walk to Freedom, written by Nelson Mandela. Today we are going to discuss part 2 of this chapter. Students, before we move on to part 2, let's recapitulate what we understood in part 1. So in part 1, we have understood the meaning of autobiography. We have seen that Nelson Mandela, how he recalled the atrocities of whites over blacks. Blacks who were blacks, natives of South Africa. We understood the meaning of apartheid. We saw the importance of 10th May for Nelson Mandela. We understood that how South African people became the proud spectators to catch the glimpse of their country's military power. And when Mr. Mandela took oath as the first black president of South Africa. So students, let's see what is there in part 2 of the chapter, A Long Walk to Freedom. Apartheid and South Africa. Nelson Mandela recalls about days gone by, which will soon be the part of history, where the whites had formed a system of racial dominance against the blacks. It was the basis of the harsh societies which was now overturned. Now means at that time when Nelson Mandela took oath. Nelson Mandela remembers that the policy of apartheid created a deep and lasting wound on this country and its people. Now there was a system that recognized the rights and freedom of all people. Regret of Mandela and remembrance of freedom fighters. Regret means when he felt sorry. So, on the auspicious day, Mandela regretted the loss of thousands of people and remembered their sacrifices for the freedom from discrimination. He paid his tribute to those people who stood by him. He thought of himself as the sum of all those African patriots who sacrificed their lives before him. He was pained that he couldn't thank them because they were not present at that time. He recalled great freedom fighters like Oliver Tambo, Walter Sisulu, Chief Luthuli, Yusuf Dadu, etc., who were the men of uncommon courage, wisdom and generosity. He said that the country is rich in minerals, but its greatest wealth is its people. Students, in the given slide, you will see some of the people who participated with Nelson Mandela in his freedom struggle. One of them was Oliver Tambo. Another one was Walter Sisulu, Chief Luthuli, Yusuf Dadu, Bram Fischer, and Robert Sobukwe. Students, Nelson Mandela points out the goodness and duties of a man. What a man must do. He was of the opinion that it is not the absence of fear, but victory over it. No one is born to hate another on the basis of color of skin or religion. If one can learn to hate, then why not learn to love with which comes naturally? He believed in the goodness of man and it never dies. He also pointed out the term twin obligations. Twin obligations means a man has to perform various obligations. Perform duties to his family, perform duties towards his community, and towards his country, which he, Nelson Mandela, did not see in his country before he pushed himself to fight for the blacks. A black man, Nelson Mandela was punished if he tried to live like a human being and forced to live apart from his own people. So he was not allowed to perform his duties to his family, his twin obligations. Students, now I will tell you what freedom was for Mr. Mandela. Mr. Mandela said he was born free. He had the freedom to run in the fields, swim in the stream, and ride on a bull. Boyhood freedom was an illusion because he was deprived of this freedom. When he grew older, he wanted the freedom of livelihood for himself and his family. But soon he realized that such freedom was only an illusion. He realized that his brothers and sisters, that means the people of South Africa who looked like him, were not free. So, for making them free, he joined African National Congress, ANC. His hunger for freedom became great for the freedom of his people. He desired that everyone should be given the right to live his life with dignity and respect. He wanted the oppressor and the oppressed to be liberated. Oppressor is a prisoner of hatred, prejudice, and narrow-mindedness. As no one is free if one is taking someone else's freedom. Only such feelings can bring true freedom for everyone. So I'm sure you will understand what Mandela meant by freedom. He wanted complete freedom for his comrades. So students, this is what Mr. Mandela wanted to point out through this chapter, A Long Walk to Freedom. So let's recapitulate what we have done in part 1 as well as in part 2. So the importance of 10th May, a day of freedom for South Africa, and there was huge gathering of international leaders and dignitaries we saw in part 1. Then we saw the inauguration ceremony, which was held in the Union Building in Pretoria, and the first non-racial government took the charge. Next, Nelson Mandela gave a speech on the victory for justice, peace, and human dignity. Then Mandela pledged to liberate his people from poverty, suffering, and discrimination. A colorful show by jets and helicopters to show military's loyalty took place. Both the blacks and the whites sang their national anthems. A new system that recognized the rights and freedom of all people was formed. Mandela remembered and thanked the people who sacrificed their lives for the freedom, his comrades. Salutation to some great freedom fighters like Oliver Tambo, Walter Sisulu, Chief Lutuli, Yusuf Dadu, and others was performed. Mandela said in speech that a country is rich because of its people, not because of the minerals. Courage is not the absence of fear, but the victory over it. People should love others and not hate them due to color or religion. Love comes naturally, not by force, which is natural goodness. Mr. Mandela also stated that a man should try to make a balance between his duties, duty to his family and duty towards his community and country. A black person, Nelson Mandela, was treated badly and not allowed to perform his duties. According to Mr. Mandela, freedom has many aspects, like for a kid, it is to run and play in the fields. For an adult, it is to fulfill the needs of his family and his own. Real freedom means equal rights for everyone. Nelson Mandela, for liberation of his people, joined the African National Congress. He desired people to live with dignity and respect. He wanted both the oppressor and the oppressed to be liberated. And at last, he says that patience and perseverance, guided by discipline and system, yield the desired results. So this was all about the chapter A Long Walk to Freedom. Part 1 and Part 2 we have recapitulated in these 14 points. So I'm sure you have understood this journey of Nelson Mandela with me. Thank you so much, students, for being patient listeners. I'm sure you are going to understand the chapter with the help of this video. Have a nice day.